Mickey. Eat that until we go. Eat it up, rich straight to the top floor. Top more PJs than PJ. Rich like water, go to Cabo. Flash. Cash in the walls, hollow. Cash. Your money too small, micro. Huncho on the call, got a. Imagine having a rim protector and not protecting the rim. Ain't your character like a 70 overall though, Tom? Wow. How tall is he? Imagine me being a better run protector than you.
That's what I'm saying. I don't know.
This nigga just made me game of the week with this bum ass. I'm about to beat the shit out of Slow Ride. Watch this.
All right, Coach, thank you. There's a look at New Era Field here in Orchard Park, New York. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Buffalo Bills. This fielded at the two. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line.
Oh, my fucking God. I need to get on my monitor, bro. I can't play my TV no more.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
So this helps to start a drive. After the penalty, it'll be first and five. Shotgun now for Wentz. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. An early statement on the game's first play. 18 yards and a first down. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory.
He can shoot that.
Alshon didn't even go for the ball, bro. Yeah, we see what type game is.
Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts.
This game about to get ugly.
Set, block the team.
Somebody gotta get off.
Flushed out right. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Play action's supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, it takes a little too long to develop. You got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble.
Red.
Second down throw for Rivers. Gonna drop this on to McCoy. Complete.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here.
What are you doing?
Whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
And that last penalty makes this third down play a little more interesting. Third and five.
Sides, bruh. Oh my god, but let me do that on my dumb ass. Oh,
shy of the 25 at the 24. His first catch there, good for 10 yards.
But he cheated, he's a playmaker.
Bro, why do you niggas keep going off? What is going on? Hold on, bro. Hold the fuck on. Cause these niggas on dickhead. What are y'all doing?
It's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
So a first and five now after the 5-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction.
Why are you looking at my plays, bro? Bro. Stop looking at my plays, Steve. For real.
Down, losing yardage back at the 27. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stop that one for a loss.
I think quarterback's
got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Now a second down throw for Rivers. Eluding the pressure right. Incomplete.
No grounding call there. He had a receiver near the right sideline. It was pretty clear there. He just needed to get rid of that one.
And he did have a receiver in the area, but initially my view was obstructed, and I thought that was going to be grounding, but clearly the correct call made, and that is no call.
Is that why you threw your play sheet down? Is that why you did it? Was that the flag?
You can't be giving me up. I got a lot of issues up here in the booth. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Now Rivers. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And it's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
How about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
Give them 12 yards on that one. It earns them a fresh set of downs. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
That's what you got. Move in the pocket. Move in the pocket.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that is caught.
What do you? What do you?
For the Eagle touchdown.
Four.
Nelson Aguilar. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Eagles have taken.
I'm back on my monitor, bro.
Elliott Good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Elliott now to kick this one away.
Pretty girl.
And this will ask not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone ask for a touchback. The Bills offense coming ask out, ready to take over. Go. And following the interception, just any interception,
you take
more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window.
I think you are. I don't think that there's anywhere you can run back out there.
Okay, no play action.
In fact, we'll just go ahead and be loose with the football again.
Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack.
Two sacks last week. Another one right here. He's been unblockable lately, and I think that goes all the way back to not just his offseason, but the film study he's been doing during the week, because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
And a few times he's even defeated double teams. He doesn't care. I got a full.
I just wanted to see.
Second down, Rivers. He's going to float this one deep right side. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Complete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
John, you good? You tweaking. You tweaking, huh?
The gun, Rivers. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Derek Barnett able to drop it for a loss of 12. And it'll be fourth down. The Bills send the punter out. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone.
Keith, this what y'all wanted to see?
Returnable here from the third.
Let's go. Cool.
It's only 7-0, but he can't move the ball to save his life.
13 yards, and the Eagles will have great starting field position. Sucking
his slow ride.
Over.
Well, you probably don't know who it is. He the Bills. Just know he got the Bills.
Their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet.
Yeah, but he's a Bills fan. That's his mom.
Scored points. It's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things.
Yeah, I don't know why
seven
the fuck he chose to be a
Bills fan.
Out of all the teams that you could have been, you picked the Bills.
Wentz to throw on second down. The reception
catch out, Sean.
By Alshon Jeffrey. And brought down, but catch not out, before Sean. They're inside the 25. Now, first catch for Jeffrey. Good enough for a first down.
Catch out, Sean. Straight appliances. It's going like 3-4 base.
They go play action here on first down. That's going to be caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles.
He got sent a picture with the little John on.
Alshon Jeffrey, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Eagles add on.
Why you were? He paid the cruise off, right, Keys?
No. Eric not going.
Oh, he not going?
No.
Why he not going?
He didn't have money to pay for the cruise. What the hell?
Why
else would somebody wouldn't go on a cruise?
I thought he wasn't going just because he ain't fuck with niggas.
We've been said it wasn't that.
Yeah, oh, so I know. Let a nigga pay this shit.
Down two touchdowns here in the first half. This
well, what money?
Drive,
man, you
said
Big Bang Eric.
Script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game.
You know, like my man Eric don't got that motherfucking guala.
12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay.
Oh, you gotta get that. You gotta get that. That's a swat.
Anything, at least 3 points.
Oh, we gotta get on that.
23 yards on the play.
Oh.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out.
He got my corner got a swat there. That's an easy swat.
When they're covered,
if you swat it,
themselves downfield and create catches.
Now a first down carry here for McCoy.
Oh God, his interior lineman, high key, just washed my interior lineman.
Schwett, who got him down on the defensive side. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now, I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit.
Got a man.
He definitely about to give him a bucket.
He definitely just, oh my God, he just threw a dot. Well, I wouldn't say it was a dot. That nigga just threw some bullshit, but still made it. What the fuck even is that?
Yes, sir. I mean, that one right there. We keep talking about the high-flying antics that we're seeing from receivers nowadays. Doesn't matter what spot they start in. But when it actually does happen in the heat of battle, brings me right out of my seat.
Working out of the gun.
No.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at the 20. So after the INT, here's Wentz. Wentz coming in.
I hate when I have a wide open man. And we let that happen.
With a great push up front, he picks up the sack and a loss of 8. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. They fake the give. Now Wentz. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. Working from the gun, Wentz. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that will fall incomplete.
This nigga don't stop running his weak-ass middle blitz, and they keep working. Fuck that shit. I'm slaying. I'm running this quick slant.
The Eagles send out their punter now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. Here's Murphy. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Bills are going to take over in great position here with a first and 10. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And 2 interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Mills. The 20, 10, and he'll score. Touchdown, Eagles.
Part of what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well. Yeah, they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick 6. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. On the return, here's Marcus Murphy.
Hold on.
Bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And now out come the Bills. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Call it a gain of 5, and it'll bring up a second down.
Red.
From the gun, Rivers. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
In the game.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback.
No lie.
But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Rivers to throw it. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed one yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, a 22.
Great
play. Has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Play action. Now wins.
Oh, yeah, he shot.
The Bills get to him.
He definitely contains that.
In there to get him. His second sack now of the afternoon. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. From the gun, it's Wins.
You lying.
That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert.
On who? They traded him for what?
A big chunk of yardage before being dropped.
Well, they traded him for what? What they get in return?
Goes for 24 yards.
Phillip Lesnar.
So the ball moves
get
from
no fucking
138
Phillip
to the other.
They damn sure not give y'all Phillip Lindsay for Joe Flacco.
Now a play fake.
They Phillip Lindsay for Joe Flacco.
And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
Not that big of a difference.
Back to the air on second down. Wentz. He's going to fire one deep. Middle of and at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. That goes for a gain of 31.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post-route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. Again, it's Wins.
Oh, I took a regular pass that to Nelson. I fought Nelson. I didn't know he was going to be that.
I can hear my high school coach right now. This is when force meets force. Gotta be physical in order to win this battle.
Yeah, that's where the physicality pays off. Nice job forcing the contact and forcing the incompletion.
Yeah, Coach Ford would have loved that play.
Again, they'll throw with Wentz. And that's gonna be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Three touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the Eagles had six to their lead.
Well, the lost sleep that the defensive coordinator had all week preparing for this game, a good portion of it was trying to prepare for him because he's absolutely a phenomenal player.
And a lot of times around the goal line, they know.
But I don't know, bro.
It's just so hard to stop.
And that's where it really becomes difficult because you're exactly right. They know it's going to.
Bro, I think, bro, I'm really getting earlys and leads, bro. It's like, I don't know, bro. I can't fucking make a full ball.
Now to kick this one away. Now it's Murphy.
You let Tune make
and
you a jumper.
Return here, he gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Dead.
Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. Typically down to the first half, I might say, oh, you at least need a field goal out of this drive, but they're down to the
yeah,
point where they need a touchdown, don't they?
Yeah, normally you know me. I mean, you've been around me for a while now, right?
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry about that. But normally I'm the one preaching patience.
Yeah,
you know,
really
take your time. First half, you still got a chance.
I think they're
out of patience here. It's this has to be a drive that gets a touchdown. So if you're the play caller, you're going to that portion of the sheet that says big time plays, specials, anything you can use to get yourself back into it.
Now Rivers. It's complete to his tight end Charles Clay. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. First catch for him on the afternoon, and it results in a first down. This give is to McCoy. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Man open right side, it's the tight end Clay. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. To throw is Rivers. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. Timmy Jernigan in there to take him down and to take us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. The Bills send the punter out as he's on to kick it away. Back to Buffalo after this. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly.
Hey, bro, if we don't got no game, give me 1 second. I got to change this bitch. I got to, bro.
Niggas wanted to see me beat the shit out of Slow Ride. Yeah, I wowed the shit.
There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down.
I will beat the dog shit out of Steve.
You're a sprinter. Get loaded in those guys.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line.
I will beat the dog shit out of Steve.
A big play there for Philly. And even 50 yards.
Yeah, he know he can't beat me. That's why he was just watching. Try to get some motherfucking tips.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Nigga trying to steal my plays and shit.
Like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment. But here, he's one that has to absorb the contact. And as a result, unable to hold on to the ball.
Nice, Steve.
To throw. It's Wentz.
That's just.
And he'll get this one down.
Nah, all the reason I say Eric is Steve stopped playing Madden for a minute.
And a quick slant gets exactly 10, and by the nose of the football, they've got a first down.
Whoa. See, that you let him fill your head with that lie.
Great 15.
Into the red zone. Wentz. And it's caught. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their
confidence. One time I don't icon. Let's go with the fucking... Now, hey, tune.
Bounce back after plays, but with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other.
Let me get the fuck off this court real quick.
How can they play better?
And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Jay Ajayi. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Eagles continue to roll.
Heard a coach talk about...
Niggas wanted to see me beat this nigga 35-0 before the end of the first half.
He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs.
I know.
Now they kick this one away. Now it's Murphy. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. Now the Bills offense gets
Steve,
ready.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Let him slice you. You see what I'm doing, Slow Ride. It's going to get worse for you.
If you got the football, you're trailing. You're back in your own territory with just a little
time.
Yeah,
I bet.
Yeah,
you better tune in.
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get...
This nigga is kneeing the ball? No, this nigga not kneeing the ball.
You may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Steve, don't put... Yeah, there you go. He's smart. He a smart nigga.
Oh, no, you better lose.
That nigga Steve is a smart nigga.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So So we've reached halftime here, and it's our visitors, the Eagles, leading this one. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
Oh, it's nice.
That was a
dream, Mike. Hey.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Now it's Murphy. Take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Out come the Bills now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are And in this case, are they upset that
the That's my man, T-Money. Shawty too ugly.
Yeah. We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better.
You just get you about to be ass again.
They'll go again to McCoy. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32.
This nigga T Money. Hey Keys, we gotta get T Money and Goodfellas on the team get down. Open, bruh. We
think Brandon that nigga get his ass whooped.
Bro, this nigga slow ride is chewing the clock and running the ball, bruh. I'm scoring.
And a loss of three to bring up four.
The best offenses and the ones that win are ones.
Shit, T Money go 7-2 then.
This team needs to open things up.
Niggas wild, bruh. Nah, we rebooting it. We went like 3-4 seasons, and then we about to go ahead and just reboot it up. But that nigga slow ride is really chewing the clock. Like, I'm not really gonna try to score. Hey Keys, I'm good, right? It's 35-0 in the third quarter. I can still score, right?
So here
I can still throw the ball until fourth quarter.
For their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, hey, you don't got Mike Evans. You don't got shit.
Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room. Because here's
what I Oh my God! Let's take
I got my grandparents.
They ain't never had no corners in the first place.
Let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down.
Vitavea, nigga.
Defense gets done.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Now Wentz on third down. Aguilar has it. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now on the afternoon.
So lightly.
If you're going to blitz, likely going to be man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is because just about any offense that has an elite receiver.
You're talking about and BML?
Even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is.
Yeah, we did a real draft.
Back-to-back gains of 17, and they are really on the march now. It's a first down. On play action, Wentz rolling to his right. Oh, he's got a man wide open.
A mid round, like a third.
Goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pickup there, 22.
As a general rule,
yeah, he could go for a third.
Like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football.
No, I flag away for first.
Get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up.
Nigga,
first down
they don't even value AB to go for a first.
On play action,
They value AB as a second round pick. Just because he's about to be 31. And I ain't know me and AB had the same birthday. We definitely getting Antonio Brown now. We got the same birthday.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run.
He's damn sure not going to the Browns. Why would they put him in their division? They're not sending him into division. They're sending him to a completely different. He's coming to the Niners.
In the first half, he was held in check on the ground.
Who don't want him? Oh, yeah, they definitely don't. Yeah, we want him, though. We'll take that problem. He's coming to.
And I think they stopped him again.
He's coming to the Niners. Right. How many times is. Yes, he is. How many times this nigga slow ride going to run the same. This nigga been running the same play this whole drive? I mean. Dotting that shit up. Hold on. God damn, Jay Jai, you don't do shit.
Brandon, at some point, these defenders absolutely have to say, we just got to make a stand. We've had enough of this.
Giving up a lot of points in this game.
I'm up 38-0. I feel like I'm getting bitched.
So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
Imagine being toxic when I'm beating the shit out of them.
The way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're on the field. But they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
I don't know why you keep thinking that. Nigga, I went like three undefeated seasons
the
in a row.
Offense now, they get set to head back on the field.
Good. And they fair sim the playoff
that's
game.
Become too familiar
and I lost.
Too many
and
of these drives just
I was mad as shit.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to,
him
to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes just out and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep him warm.
It, bro. He keep chew clocking, bro.
Right now from all the work he's getting.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Yes. He should be trying to score himself. Why is he not trying to score himself? The game not over to the fat lady sing.
And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more.
He blowing it, bro. He really chew clocking, bro.
Fuck. Brings him down.
When I'm losing like this, bro, I don't never chew clock, bro. I'm trying to score.
Plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Bro. Oh, my God, bro.
Back now in Buffalo.
Mike, shut your short ass up, short bitch.
The Bills on third down. Nigga. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. This will be third and 5.
Yes. That's the exact reason I'm mad.
Off the play fake here.
Now he want to throw the ball. Go get his ass.
He's going to sling this deep down. He's got a man. Complete.
Oh, my God. The one time he throw the damn ball.
Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about